period's not up, Hargensen.
Betty Buckley has been called a national treasure. As a performer, she's done it all. She won the Tony in 1983 for her now iconic performance as Grisabella in the musical Cats. She warmed hearts as a stepmom in the hit television show Eight Is Enough for 5 seasons. Countless film and TV and stage performances have followed. And she is still going strong. Her heart is as big as her native Texas. And when Desert AIDS Project reached out to her to be part of their upcoming Voices for Hope virtual concert, Friday at 7 p.m., she jumped at the chance.
So great to see you. And I feel like I can say Betty Lynn because of our Texas connection.
Absolutely. You have to. Yeah.
Well, we are so excited to have you part of our wonderful fundraiser for Desert AIDS Project.
So this project is amazing, and what Desert AIDS Project does for people of various races and, people that have AIDS or have medical challenges and various ages. People that are homeless, they help them. They help people get medical care, and it's amazing. And they've grown and grown and grown since they started in 1984 and have grown since then. So I'm really honored to be a part of it.
Tell me how you've managed to kind of stay busy and keep everything kind of lubricated and working.
Well, from the beginning, when we were in New York, my second week of my engagement at the Cafe Carlyle was canceled. So my wonderful assistant of 20 years, Kathy, and I elected to drive home. Despite our best efforts, both of us got very sick on the return. Kathy tested positive for COVID and was really sicker than I've ever seen her. And she lives in the guest house on my ranch. So we were communicating from the yard. Now, I was sick too, not as sick as she was, but I tested negative for COVID, although I feel it was a really unusual version of illness that I've never quite had before. So I sensed that perhaps those tests were inconclusive or, a false negative.
Through all of this, what has been your silver lining? Is there just one silver lining or have there been so many?
Well, I'm really blessed to live on this ranch. It's like living on a park, in a park. In fact, people that have come to visit me says, oh my God, you live in a park. It's beautiful and there are trees and wildlife and stuff. And so just taking a walk here is very inspirational. I do believe it's about, things that have been underneath our culture for a long time, coming to the surface for us to really see it so boldly that we're inspired to choose again and to say no to cruelty, no to inhumanity.
And will you promise you'll come visit us in Palm Desert when all of this, Palm Springs?
For sure. It's so nice to see you again, Sandy. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you so much, Betty Lynn.